Now that we've worked with patching some conventional fixtures onto our Cobalt, let's take a look at patching some more advanced multiple parameter fixtures. To do this, we'll navigate into the browser, go to the patching window, and navigate down to Import Template Wizard. Before we start patching in our individual fixtures, we need to add a few things into our show file. Inside of the Import Template Wizard, we have an Import From category. Under here are two options, the Extended Library and the Standard Library. The Standard Library is what we recommend to use most, but every once in a while there won't be a fixture inside of the Standard Library that you might find in the Extended Library. Always check Standard first. So we'll select our Standard Library. Underneath this, we have two options, Manufacturer and Device. Manufacturer is a list of all of the major lighting manufacturers. For now, we're going to go down and find Generic. Underneath that list is a series of devices. These are all of the different fixtures that a particular manufacturer makes, or in this case of Generic, fairly common fixtures. Inside of this for right now, we're going to start with an LED RGB light. So find RGB, hit Modify, navigate down to Execute, and hit Modify again. You'll notice under Import Templates that we've now added RGB to our list of used templates. Previously, by default, we had Scroller, Scroller Speed, and Fan. Now we've added RGB and we're ready to start patching it. Hit Escape to get out of the Import Template Wizard and go down to the Patch Wizard. Hit Modify to select that. Navigate to the right using the arrow keys to patch device. Just like we did when we patched scrollers, we're going to use this window to create our fixtures in the show. Hit Modify under Type of Device. Navigate down to RGB to select that we want to patch RGB LED fixtures. Navigate down to Number of Devices, type in a number. In this case, we're going to patch in 17 lights and hit Modify. Navigate down again to Starting at Desk Channel. What channel do we want these lights to start at? 36, and hit Modify. And again, navigate down to DMX Address. These particular fixtures in our rig start at 101. So I'll type in 101 and hit Modify. Unlike what we did previously, we will leave Replace Existing Dimmer selected. There is no scroller roll, so we'll leave this blank, and navigate down to Execute and hit Modify. We'll get a dialog box saying that 17 devices have been patched, and we can see the channel list for more details. Hit OK, and hit Escape to step out. Take a look at what 36 through 52 look like in live now. You'll notice that two things have changed. One, they now have a little white dot next to 36, or next to the channel number. And two, they now have an RGB listing. This is telling us the current color of the fixture, white, since we haven't done anything with it yet, and what type of fixture is patched in there. If we want to work on something like a moving light, navigate up to our Import Template Wizard, hit Modify to select that. Again, switching back to the Standard Library, we'll go into Manufacture. If I hit the M key on my keyboard, it'll take me directly down to the M manufacturers, and I don't have to scroll all the way through. We'll select Martin, come into Device, and scroll down and find one of the fixtures we want. In this case, let's patch a Mac 2000. We find the fixture we want, Mac 2K profile, hit Modify, navigate down to Execute, and hit Execute to add it to our list. Escape to get us back out. Navigate to the Patch Wizard, over to Patch Device, select the type of device we want. Number of devices, we're going to patch 4 of these. Where do I want it to start? 91 and Modify. However, this time, I want to select a different DMX universe. So we'll go ahead and select the universe we want, 2, and Modify. Navigate up to the DMX address and type in the particular address you want and hit Modify. These lights start at 127. Navigate down to Execute and hit Modify, and we'll patch those fixtures in. Escape gets us back to live. And notice that there's even more information represented under channel 91 through 94. Once we've imported all of these different devices and built our entire rig, it's a really good idea to save.